is so brave. No way I could have done what she did.
And without a leg, too.
Wait, what?
She lost her leg when she was a kid.
Stepped on a landmine in a field near her house.
So wait, how does she...
She has a prosthetic leg. A good one.
Good, because crossing the border into Pakistan is not easy, even if you have both your legs.
That's what the prompt is getting at, right? Two central ideas in this excerpt are survival and helping others. Write a response in which you analyze the development of these two ideas and their interactions in the course of the text.
Survival and helping others.
Look at the example of how she lost her leg. She survived the explosion of the landmine, and then she got some help when she was airlifted to Germany to get her surgery and prosthetic leg.
So you're saying that survival and helping others aren't just themes in this book. They're themes in Farah's life?
That would make sense, right? I mean, it is a memoir.
Well, let's see if we can find some more examples.
I see lots of examples of surviving. Even in that first paragraph, Farah and her mother are desperate to stay alive.
Oh yeah, like here. I felt desperate to get through. Because the sun was setting, and if we got stuck here, what were we going to do? Where would we stay? There was nothing here. No town, no hotel, no buildings. Just the desert.
Sounds like a nightmare.
Except it's real.
But they don't get through, and they do survive.
Hey, so did you all do the background research like Miss Carter asked?
I did, yeah. It looks like the war had been going on in Afghanistan for a long time.
But whose war was it? Started off against the Soviet Union, but by the late 1990s, when this takes place, it's hard to say.
Yeah, it seems like the forces that were originally fighting the Soviets have now turned against each other.
The Taliban was in Kabul by then too, near where Farah and her family lived. They could have been the ones who put in the landmine.
Sounds like a really dangerous place.
No wonder Farah and her mother wanted to leave.
But how come Pakistan isn't letting them in?
Well, they're not exactly not letting them in. Listen to this. On that second day, however, I learned that it was all a question of money. The guards are taking bribes to let the people through.
So, is that an example of helping others?
You mean, are the guards helping the refugees by taking their money?
They're letting them through.
But Farah and her mother don't have any money.
Yeah, and what money they do have, they're gonna need. It says, we do not have the money to pay them. What little we had, we would need to get from Peshawar to Quetta.
But back to Morgan's question. I think the answer is no. This is not an example of the guards helping others. They're basically robbing people who have nothing.
Yeah, I guess. I think I was just looking for some hope.
Well, it comes, because that night, Farah and her mom meet Ghulam Ali.
Oh yeah, that's lucky.
Wait, who is that again?
He's that nice man who finds a secret path into Pakistan.
When his wife tells him Farah's story, he agrees to take care of them.
See, now that's helping others.
He doesn't want anything in exchange, just wants to help.
But his plan, it's not easy.
No way. They have to spend another hard day in the desert with no water.
And once they do start hiking, Farah's mom's asthma starts kicking in pretty bad.
What about Farah? Didn't you say she lost her leg?
She talks about that. She said she was feeling really good and strong that day. She was faster than the other kids.
Yeah, she says, I don't know what made me so supple and strong that day, but I felt no hardship, no anxiety or fear, just concentration and intensity. Perhaps my mother's problems distracted me from my own. That might account for it. Perhaps desperation gave me energy and made me forget the rigor of the climb. Well, whatever the reason, I scrambled up like a goat.
Good for her.
It's interesting that the reasons she lists are all negative.
What do you mean?
She's saying maybe I was so worried and or desperate that I didn't notice my leg. Not exactly positive thinking.
That's true. In the commercials when the guy is climbing the mountain, he's thinking, I can do this. I'm the best.
That's not how Farah's mind works.
But also she's not trying to achieve an athletic goal. She's trying to survive. She's a survivor.
Yeah, I mean, I think she worries about all this stuff because it's real. She's already lost more in her life than any of us ever will.
But she's found a way to turn that fear and worry into, I don't know, energy.
Yeah, it's like that drive to survive is literally sending her up and over the mountain.
But unlike in the desert, this time she has some help.
Yeah, this time Farah and her mother have Ghulam Ali. Listen to what she says about him. That Ghulam Ali was certainly a good man, so patient with us and so compassionate. He had never seen us before, and yet when he met us, he said, I will help you.
That was very nice of him. I mean, he's probably worried about getting his family across. Imagine taking on a girl with one leg and a mom with asthma. They could really slow him down.
And they do. Well, not Farah, but her mom can't move that fast.
But Ghulam Ali was patient and even complimented Farah for moving so quickly.
It's the impact of his kindness that's really so amazing, right? Listen to what Farah says. I have felt alone in this world at times. I have known long periods of being no one. But then, without warning, a person like Ghulam Ali just turns up and says, I see you. I am on your side.
What does she mean by being no one?
Think about the crowds of refugees trying to enter Pakistan. The way the guards beat them back. Imagine how powerless you must feel.
Like you don't matter. Like you're nobody.
But that's Farah's secret. She learned two important things, how to survive and how to trust in kindness when it matters most.
I love this line at the end. Strangers have been kind to me when it mattered most. That sustains a person's hope and faith.
People are good, people.
Some of them are messed up in the head like those greedy guards.
Farah's known a lot of hardships, but she still believes in goodness.
I can't wait to see what happens when she and her mom get to the U.S.
I bet there will be more challenges ahead.
Farah can take it. She's one of the strongest people I know.
Oh, so do you know her now?
I kind of feel like I do. Yeah.